Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review or overview, and today I have something very exciting for you because these are knives that you don't see that often on YouTube, on Instagram or anywhere else, because there are only about 28 of these at the moment in the world. And of course we're talking about something from Quist Blade Works, which is a newer custom knife maker that also has already collaborated in producing his production knife, which is the Variant PE right here that I managed to get one. And he also does custom knives, also started out doing custom knives, of course. And today we're actually getting the opportunity to take a look at two custom knives of his knives that he built. And I said before, only 28 of these knives have been built up to this date. And today is the 11th of April of 2022. So a newer maker that is doing some very interesting stuff. And these two are also special in another particular way, because these are both Star Wars themed. These are not my knives. These were loaned to me very generously by a gentleman on Instagram that lives here in Europe. And I will link his Instagram in the description below. So now let's take a look at all this swag we got here on the table. There is a separate review of the production PE version of the Variant on my channel already. This is made by QSP, very affordable. Got some nice Sandvik steel, 14C28N on the blade steel. It's very well made and really captures the essence of the Variant design by Jacob Lundquist, who is the guy behind Quist Bladeworks. So if you're interested in the production version, please check out their video on the channel. It will be linked in the top right corner. Today we're going to focus on the custom folders. First up, in the packaging on the customs, you notice they are a bit thicker than the ones on the production knives. And you're getting, in the newer ones, you're actually getting this very cool 3D printed insert that he includes with your custom knife. You have this little latch that opens, you get the Quist Bladeworks logo on there, and then you're getting a lanyard right there that you can put on or leave off your knife. And then you are getting a very cool leather clip slip done by Weaver or Weaver Leather, also in the USA, with that nice spring pocket clip. And you can also choose the color of your leather. My friend chose red for his knife here. Also, I only have the full packaging for one of the knives, because one was back for warranty work and the other one was a new build. So this is the only leather slip case I can show you. So this is a clip slip that is also made in the USA, in Minnesota. Everything that you're getting from Quist Bladeworks is actually made in the US, except of course for the production versions, and he really puts an emphasis on that. Here you also see you're getting all the tools you need to take your knife apart, cradled in this very cool blue 3D printed insert. So really cool little addition. He likes to toy around with some new machines, some new ways of doing things, and that certainly shows you here on this very cool kind of packaging deal that he does on his customs. Also, it's very hard to get one of his customs. As I said before, only a handful, 28, have already been made, and it's very, very hard to get on that list. And you certainly will see why, because he got quite a bit of hype when his production version launched, because people then kind of understood how well this design works and how nicely it is done. Also, you saw you get a clip slip with the knife. That is also because his customs don't have a pocket clip. The production version here, the PE, actually has an included pocket clip. So that's also an interesting and important information to know. So let's put the packaging out of the way, and now let's take a look at one of the great custom knives that were loaned in by Guillaume Opsomer, which is the generous viewer that actually loaned these knives in for this little overview. And you can see we have a very, very nicely done knife here in some multicolored, multi-layer G10 scales with the Mudhorn insignia from Star Wars, very cleanly milled into the handle right there by Mr. Jacob Lundquist. We got some nice titanium hardware by Tie Connector, and then the blade itself, you can see the milling marks still left on the blade. You can feel them, but they don't do any kind of hang up or things like that when you're actually cutting, so they're very shallow. They're not very deep gouges, so it's just a very interesting visual appeal. and shows you a little bit the way that the knife was made, but it doesn't detract from it in any way while actually using it. Of course, we got the same kind of deployment hole that we have on the PE version. This is just called the variant without the PE. That's the model name. Nice dark tumbled finish on the blade, and this is made from Elmax steel. There are two different steels that Jacob Lundquist is using on his custom folders at the moment. It's Elmax and S45VN, so two US steels, high-end US steels, powder metallurgy technology. And Mr. Lundquist really puts an emphasis on having everything made in North America. We saw the leather clip slips before that were made in Minnesota. And then he also works with a company in Canada called Focusworks that does some of the machining on the blades right there. And everything else then is done by Jacob in his shop. He also has a CNC, I believe, and he has some other tools that he works on the knives. And of course, there is a lot of handwork involved in building these custom pieces. One thing I have to mention, the grinds on these knives are insane. These are so incredibly sharp. Of course, I received them directly from the maker, so these are is the sharpest they're ever going to be. But wow, this is an absolute slicing machine. You only got about a 3mm blade stock right there, a good tip here in front, and the edge is done so incredibly well. Very, very, very sharp. Scary sharp, actually. Then the hardware here is titanium hardware from Ty Connector. We got a inset liner lock that also has some very nice finishing on there, some kind of satiny finish, also a broken edge there, so it's very comfortable to disengage that. And this is also a titanium liner lock. Lockup is perfect, absolutely no kind of wiggle in any direction. And the action here on this one is not as free-falling as on the newer one, but still very, very well done here on the action. Very, very smooth overall, running on bearings, I believe also from Ty Connector. And it's just an absolutely gorgeous piece. And you have to keep in mind, this is only the fourth knife that Jacob Lundquist has made and sold. And everything is marked here on the inside. You can see here you have the Quist logo and 004. For the serial number, and on the other side we have a proudly made in North America kind of cool tag that is also milled in on the inside. And everything is done with so much care, and this just feels so good in the hand without the pocket clip to cause any kind of hot spot. We got some minimal hardware, two in the back, and then the decorative pivot screw right there. On the other side, of course, we get the flush mounted screws for your inset titanium liner lock. And just an absolutely cool design and so well done. Super, super slim, so very, very easy to carry. Of course, if you carry it in your clip slip, that is going to add a little bit of weight. But if you carry this just in the pocket, this certainly is a super slim knife, and it's even slimmer than your production version. You can see that here. It feels actually substantially slimmer in the hand than the production PE version, and much, much lighter weight. Here we have stainless steel liners on both sides. Here we only have that titanium liner, and this only weighs 57 grams or 2 ounces, so super, super lightweight. In terms of overall length, we have here 17.5 centimeter overall, or 6.9 inches, with a blade length of 7.5 centimeters or 2.95 inches, so just under 3 inches there if that is a legal issue where you live. And then we have a handle length of about 10 centimeters or 3.94 inches. So very nice and compact EDC blade size here on the variant. As I said before, this is a very lightweight version at only 2 ounces. And price-wise, these custom knives are insanely affordable. They go around the $300 range, a bit more, a bit less, depending on the materials, but that is insane for the quality and the overall attention to detail that you're getting here on these Qvist variant. I think that's also one of the reasons that these are so hard to get to, because as I said before, only 28 are made. I got two of them here on the channel at the moment, and he only does this as a part-time gig, so he certainly needs some time to get these knives made. So don't pester him and get him all stressed out, but it's certainly something you should keep in your mind if you want to get an absolutely amazing custom knife at a very affordable price point with a super unique take on things, and just a maker that is absolutely delivering on all fronts here in terms of quality, design, where it's made, all the transparency, the way he interacts on Instagram and everywhere with the community, and bringing out production versions for the ones that don't have $300 to spend on a knife. He really covers the whole thing very, very well, and certainly has an eye for design, and that shows in these knives as well. Now let's take a look at the other one that I have here on the channel for overview, and that is this one here. This is modeled after the X-Wing, which is a spacecraft from the Rebel Alliance in Star Wars, and just so many details here on this Qvist variant. This is the newest model, the model 28, or the serial number 28. And this also is in S45VN, so absolutely amazing. We have aluminum scales with a nice light distressed brushed finish, and we got these nice milled in lines and dots that are like bolts and plates. And then we got the Rebel insignia right there, absolutely gorgeously done there. And then we got these inlays of red Alutex, same kind of inlay titanium liner lock, just so well done. Different type of tie connector hardware, a little bit a lighter finish on the blade, same Qvist Bladeworks logo, and the action here is even more impressive on the newer ones. I don't know if he changed the bearings that he uses on his folders, but the action on this thing here is insane. And of course, my preferred method to opening these, as it is on my production variant, is the middle finger flick, and that works perfectly. But you can also, of course, use your thumb to open it, and you can also do it slowly and controlled if you don't want to scare anybody. Of course, sizes and everything will be the same, but weight is a bit different. This is slightly heavier. This comes in at 73 grams or 2.57 ounces, so still super light, but almost half an ounce heavier than the full G10 version down right there. And here we have some very interesting and cool details on the inside as well. We got the same made in North America badge, of course. We got also the same Qvist Bladeworks and the model number here, 28, and the Qvist logo. But then we got another great thing milled on the inside here. Rebellions are built on hope on the inside there. A little bit of a nod to the overall theme we have here with that X-Wing from the Rebellion in Star Wars. So very, very cool attention to detail. And that just shows you what kind of projects Mr. Lundqvist is actually up to taking in his custom builds. Same overall construction, standoffs in the back right there. It feels a tiny bit thicker in the hand because of that rounded aluminum all the way around right there, but it certainly feels super, super comfortable. Because it's a tiny bit thicker and so rounded, it really melts into your hand. Same amazing edge on there, same amazing blade profile. Just an absolutely gorgeous piece, and you can see here, his knives are just so unique, something so different from all the other things you see on the market right there. He really popularized this swayback pattern, especially in a modern locking folder with a great action. And all the different variants that he built in terms of the costumes are listed on his website, so you can see what different styles he already has produced so far. And if there is an opening on his books anytime soon, I will certainly absolutely jump on it. I would love to have one of these knives, even though I would certainly prefer to have a pocket clip on mine, but so far he is not willing to do this because he absolutely loves the ergonomics that a clipless knife provides. That is certainly something you can't argue with, but I certainly would love to have a clip on my folders. I just noticed that I really don't carry the knives that don't have a clip, that rely on a clip slip or are just carried loosely in the pocket. I just lose them, they fall out, they get scratched up. But the knives that you see right here are just insanely nice. Love all the choices he has made. The action is incredible. The size is great for an EDC piece. And the prices for custom knives are absolutely amazing. I have not shown you yet the card you're getting with your custom Quist Bladeworks. We get your serial number here, the name or the handle is Aluminum X-Wing Rebel S35VN Blasted Stonewashed Blade Bare Titanium Hardware. Then you get the sheath, and when it's made, signed by the maker. And if you're interested in these knives, please check out Jacob Lundquist and Quist Bladeworks on Instagram at Quist_Bladeworks, and also check out his website quistbladeworks.com, and certainly a maker to keep an eye out for, and to see what production knives he is actually coming out with. He has a different design that he is at the moment trying to get produced, so certainly something very interesting coming here from Mr. Lundquist. And now let's do some size comparisons on these customs so you just can get a feel. I will do it on the X-Wing model and put the other one a bit to the side just as some eye candy, maybe put the production one right there. So we have our standard Chirogorov sandwich. Here we have the F95NL, and then we get the Neon Zero. And you can see it's certainly smaller than both of these. And then we have our benchmark EDC blades, which is of course a full-sized Benchmade Bug Out, which is also larger. And then we got the Para 3, which is much closer in overall size, much closer in overall blade length. And let's take a look at thickness. It's also really close. It's a bit thinner than a Para 3. This is the thicker of the two. If you take a look here, you can see that the full G10 one is certainly thinner than the Para 3. And then maybe we can take a look at blade stock comparison to a Bug Out. It is a bit thicker in terms of tip strength. They are very close. And then another knife, or a couple other knives that I think are good comparisons here on the Quist, is for example an Insingo Sebenza 21. Size wise, you see these are very similar, but you get quite a bit more of height in the Quist Bladeworks variant. And then I have the Quiet Carry Drift, also a knife that reminded me a little bit of that Quist. And you can see size-wise, these are very close. Here we get the similarity of the opening hole as well. And I think these two are certainly also a good comparison overall. The Drift is even slimmer in blade stock as well as in the handle. And it got a great clip. A clip like this would certainly be awesome on the variant. I would absolutely love such an understated clip. It doesn't really take away from the overall design. It doesn't really add any kind of hotspot when using the knife, but you still get a great clip on your folder. And these knives have a tiny bit of lockstick sometimes, but not something I would be concerned about, and I think that will go away in use. I only had these for a couple of days just to oogle them and to check them out, but just absolutely awesome. And thanks again very much to my friend Guillaume for actually loaning these in. I'm very happy that I could actually experience a custom Quist Bladeworks variant, since I'm so in love with the PE version. And on the PE versions, you're actually are getting a version 2 that is a front flipper, and you also can get some titanium scales for your regular as well as your version 2 PEs in the future. So stay tuned for more infos on that at the Quist Bladeworks website and Instagram. And here a last shot of these two absolutely amazing custom knives in their own Star Wars theme. Absolutely gorgeous, representing also the two blade steels that you're getting, and everything here is made in North America, so Canada and the US. And just an absolutely amazing piece, especially considering the price and that these are made by a part-time custom knife maker, which is of course Jacob Lundquist. So thanks again for watching. I hope you had a great time watching these knives, and I hope I can give you some information on this new maker that is just doing some incredible stuff. And thank you for watching. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to follow me at @severity_knife_reviews on Instagram. And stay tuned for some more content like this. Have a nice day and goodbye.